In this video, I am going to explain the intermediate code generation. So this is the second part of the unit 3. So what is meant by intermediate code generation means, this is the fourth phase of any compilation process. So in this intermediate code generation, we are going to generate a 3 address code. So what is the main outline of this intermediate code generation means? So in this video, we are going to discuss the topics on outline of variants of syntax tree, 3 address code, types and declarations, translation of expressions, their type checking and control flow, and back patching. So coming to the introduction about the intermediate code generation. The intermediate code is a interface between the front and back end of a compiler. So here front end is nothing but 3 phases of the compilation. So that is the first 3 phases of a compilation, that is lexical analysis, syntax analysis and a semantic analysis. So while completion of the semantic analysis, we are going to generate a parse tree with semantical meaning along with the type checker. So that will be given to the intermediate code. So after that, in the intermediate code, we are going to generate a 3 address code. So in the 3 address code, we are going to generate a quadruples, triples, indirect indexing also. These are the forms of the indirect 3 addressing code. So this next back end of a compiler will be the next 3 phases of a compilation process, that is code optimization and the code generation, including also intermediate code generation. So the ideally the details of the source language are conformed to the front end and the details of the target machine to the back end. So that means that initial data will be given to the source language, that is conformed as a front end. And the rest of the data, whatever we are going to generate, that data will be called as a backend, that is the target machine. So in this chapter, we are going to study the intermediate representation like static type checking and intermediate code generation. The position of a intermediate code generator will be the, so first we are going to take the lexical analyzer. In the lexical analyzer, we are going to generate the lexemes or tokens. So that will be given to the parser. In the parser, we are going to construct a tree, parse tree. So after that, next we are going to give up that to semantic analysis. In the semantic analysis, we are going to check the type checking. So after that, again we are going to generate a construction of syntax tree or abstract syntax tree with a semantical meaning. So that input will be given to the intermediate code generator. In the intermediate code generator, we are going to generate a 3 address code. So next we are going to give up that code to the code optimization phase. This is the optional phase. After that code optimization, we are going to generate code generator. Next one, variants of syntax tree. So it is sometimes beneficial to create DAG instead of tree for representation. If you want to see the example for this one, so what is the expression they are given? A plus A star B minus C plus B minus C star with D. So first we are going to compute the expression like B minus C along with, again we are having one more expression B minus C. So that will be multiplied with D now. So B minus C star with D, and we are going to construct this B minus C with the star with A and plus with A, and finally we are going to add up these two expressions. So that means that and the next one will be the syntax directed definition for creating DAGs. So in the syntax directed definition, we are having a productions. So what are the productions we are having means, e tends to even plus t, e tends to even minus t, e tends to t, t tends to braces e, t tends to id, and the t tends to number. So these are the semantic rules for these productions. So how we are going to construct these semantic rules means, so initially if you want to see a production, e tends to even plus t. So in this production, so every node will be taken as a attribute. So that means that e dot node is equal to new node construction of, so plus is nothing but a root node, and even node will be the left, and t node will be the right node. So that means that e tends to even plus t. So we are going to create a new node. So in this new node, first we are going to create a plus node. In the plus node, we are having the even value as well as t dot value, that is the right value. So then we are going to do the summation for these two values. Likewise, we are going to take the another production, e tends to even minus t. So in this even minus t, we are going to create a new node, that is the minus, this will be the root node. So next one will be the left node and the right node. So coming to the e tends to t, only one node value will be there. Directly we are going to assign this node value to the e node. So next one, t tends to braces of E. So here there is no arithmetic product, arithmetic function will be there. So directly we are going to assign E dot node value to the T dot node value. So likewise we are going to see the next productions also. If you want to see the example for this one, so first we are going to create a, so this is an example for the construction of the DAG. For this A tends to, this is the example for how we are going to construct the syntax tree and DAG. So in this expression, first we are going to take the A plus A star B minus C and B minus C star with D. So first we are going to construct these two as two parts. This is a part 1 and next this part will be the part 2. So first in this process, first we are going to take it as A B minus C. So that means that A will be the leaf node. So first we are going to create a leaf node. So next one, then we are going to create another leaf node. Then likewise B and C we are going to construct. After that we are going to perform the operation as B minus C. So we are going to construct a node. So in that node, what is the operation we are going to perform? Minus, and B value should be there in the P2 and the C value should be there in the P4. So then that will be stored in the P5. So next we are going to multiply that into the A. So we are going to, and again we are going to create a node star. So then that will be multiplied with A. So A will be stored in P2 and this P minus C operation resultant will be stored in the P5. So likewise next, then we are going to add up the total resultant up to this, we are going to P6. So this will be added to the A. So again we are going to create a node A, node plus. So in the left we are going to take it as a P1, that is a A node, and in the right we are going to construct this one. So likewise we are going to construct the second part also. So first we are going to create a B and C leafy nodes. So after that we are going to perform the minus. So minus for this operation B minus C. So that's why we are going to construct a node. So this is the root value and this will be the left value and this will be the right value. So what is the operation we are going to perform means B minus C, that will be stored in the P10. So next, again we are going to create a P11, so that is a leafy node. Why? Because of next operation will be the B minus C star with D. So already B minus C value will be there in the P10. So next we are going to create a ID for D. So node creation, this will be multiplied with left value as a P11, P10, and the right value will be P11. So finally we are going to add up these two expressions, that is P3 node, summation of the left value as well as the right value. So this total resultant will be there in the P7 here. So P7, and this second part will be there in the P12. So P12. So this will be constructed in the syntax tree format as, first we are going to construct a B value and C value. So then we are going to perform the B minus C, and that should be star with A, star with A, and that should be plus with A. So this is the part 1, and coming to the second part, B minus C first we are going to construct. So that should be multiplied with a D, and so this total part 1 and part 2 will be summation with the plus. So these values will be the storing values P1, P2, P3. So here P1 value. So next this is a P2 value. Likewise we are going to take up. So this is a DAG representation. So DAG is nothing but if any work will be there, repetition of work means, so that we are going to remove. So here B minus C, two times computation will be there. So that work we are going to remove. So only directly we are going to connect the B minus C. As well as here also, we are going to store the identifier A value in two times. So that we are going to reduce. DAG is nothing but we are going to reduce the work, whatever the computation we are going to perform, two or more times. The DAGs will be constructed by the method of constructing the DAGs method, that is the algorithm is also there. So in this example, if you want to see this, first we are going to compute the I plus 10. So that should be assigned to I again. That means that what is the expression here? I equal to I plus 10. Suppose if you want to take a value of I will be 2 means, so first we are going to perform the operation as 2 plus 10. So that should be stored in the I, that is 12 is the value, right? So next, what is the algorithm means? So if you want to see the algorithm here, so the searching algorithm node M with labeled with operator left value as well as right value. In the previous example also we are seeing that example. So if you want to create a node, so that node which contains a label value, that is operation value, and the left value, left child and the right child. If there is a such node, so then must and should it having a returning value. If not, create in the array a node n with label operator, left child and right child. So its return value will be the true value. And next one, three address code. So a three address code is a one of the type or one of the form of the intermediate code generation. So if you want to see this example, so in this DAG representation, so we are going to perform the B minus C operation. So that should be multiplied with A and plus with A. So and here also B minus C, that should be star with D and plus with this total operation. So that means that, so the expression will be A plus B minus C star with A plus with A and plus with B minus C star with D. This is the expression. So how we are going to write up the three addressing code for this DAG representation means, first we are going to perform the B minus C. So that should be stored in the temporary variable as a T1. So after that, next multiplied with A. So that should be stored in the temporary variable T2. So after that, next we are going to perform this value into the plus with A. So then T3 equal to A plus this T2 value. So next one, T4 equal to, so this value will be B minus C now. So B minus C and star with D. So T1 star with D. So then finally we are going to do the summation of these two values. So that is a T3 plus T4. This is the three address notation for this DAG representation. So next one, forms of the three addressing code. So first we need to see the instructions of the three addressing code. So the first instruction will be x equal to y operator z, and the next instruction will be x equal to operator y, and next one x equal to y, then go to L. So if x go to L, and if false, it goes to some other place. If x relational operator y, then go to L. That means that x less than or equal to y, x greater than or equal to y also we are going to instruct. Next one, procedure calls using the x. So parameter x we are going to take, then call p comma n means, suppose if you want to take a function as y equal to call of p comma n, so then we are going to call up the values of p as well as the n values. So then directly we are going to assign the array values to the variables also, and array values to the directly to the values also, and we are going to take the pointers also. So next one, example. So in this example, how we are going to construct a three address code for this expression. So if you want to see the expression, so what is the expression they are given? Do equal do I equal to I plus 1 while A of I which is less than or equal to V. Here we are going to take up the example as a do while expression. That means that, so if the condition will be fail means until that the do case statements will be executed. So first I am going to take a temporary variable T1 that should be stored in the I plus 1. So next that should be assigned to I equal to T plus 1. So first I equal to, first we are going to take the temporary variable I plus 1 that should be stored in T1. So then that should be assigned to I. So after that, next we are going to do some computations. This is a computation for checking this condition, while condition. So if it is true only, then it will go to this label. And this is the position of the numbers. That means that, so in which memory location or in which indexing number the value should be stored. This is the indexing or memory addresses. So next, data structure for three addressing codes. So we are having three types of three addressing codes are to be there: quadruples, triples, indirect triples. So this is a very very important topic and important question. So in the quadruples we are having the four fields. One is the operator, argument 1, argument 2 and the result. In the triple we are having the three fields. So in the indirect triple we are having the same as it is triples, but indirect indexing we are going to mention. So if you want to see the example for this one, so in this example B star minus C plus B star minus C, unary minus we are going to take. So that means that in the quadruples we are going to take the how many fields. So we are going to take the four fields. So operator, argument 1, argument 2 and the result. So first we are going to perform the B star minus C. So plus B star minus C. Here minus C will be the unary minus operator. So that's why we are going to mention this as a minus. So first operator will be the minus. So and the argument will be the variable names C. So after that, this minus value should be multiplied with b. So then operator will be star. So argument 1 will be the this b1 and argument 2 will be the, so this value will be stored in t1 now. So t1. So that resultant will be stored in the t2. Likewise, so we are going to compute the next part also. Unary minus, so minus c, that should be stored in the t3, and we are going to multiply that value into b. So star operator will be the star and b. So the minus value will be there in the t3. So that should be stored in the t4. So then we are going to perform the addition between these two operations, that is plus. So this left part will be stored in the t2 and this right part will be stored in the t5. So t4. So then the resultant will be t5. So this should be assigned. So next a equal to, actually this statement will be the a equal to b star minus c plus b star minus c. So finally we are going to assign that value into the a.